Hello, today on this podcast of chapter 5, challenges to and restoration of the Congress system, you are listening to Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start with 4th general election 1967. The year 1967 is considered a landmark year in India's political and electoral history. Party was the dominant political force throughout the country from 1952 onward. This trend was to undergo significant change with the 1967 elections. First, we talk on the context of the elections. In the years leading up to the 4th general election, the country witnessed major changes. Two prime ministers had died in quick succession, and the new prime minister, who was being seen as a political novice, has been in office for less than a year. The period was fraught with grave economic crises resulting from successive failure of monsoon, widespread droughts, decline in agricultural production, serious food shortage, depletion of foreign exchange reserves, drop in industrial production and export, combined with a sharp rise in military expenditure and diversion of resources from planning and economic development. One of the first decisions of the Indira Gandhi government was to devaluate the Indian rupee, under what was seen to be a pressure from the US. Earlier, $1 could be purchased for less than rupees 5. After devaluation, it cost more than rupees 7. The economic situation triggered off price rise. People started protesting against the increase in prices of the essential commodities, food scarcity, growing unemployment, and the overall economic condition in the country. Bands and hadtals were called frequently across the country. The government saw the protests as a law and order problem and not as the expression of the people's problem. This further increased the public bitterness and reinforced popular unrest. The Communist and the Socialist Party launched struggles for great equality. A group of communists who separated from the Communist Party of India Marxist to form the Communist Party of India Marxist-Leninist led armed agrarian struggle and organized peasants' agitations. This period also witnessed some of the worst Hindu-Muslim riots since independence. Now let us discuss on the non-congressism. This situation could not have remained isolated from party politics in the country. Opposition parties were in the forefront of organizing public protests and pressurizing the government. Parties opposed to the Congress realized that the division of their vote kept the Congress in power. Thus, the parties that were entirely different and desperate in their programs and ideologies got together to form anti-Congress front in some states and entered into electoral adjustment of sharing seats in others. They felt that the inexperience of Indira Gandhi and the internal factionalism within the Congress provided them an opportunity to topple the Congress. The socialist leader Ram Manohar Lohia gave this strategy the name of non-Congressism. He also produced a theoretical argument in its defense. Congress rule was undemocratic and opposed to the interest of the ordinary poor people. Therefore, the coming together of the non-Congress parties was necessary for reclaiming democracy for the people. Now, what was electoral verdict? It was in this context of heightened popular discontent and the polarization of political forces that the fourth general elections to the Lok Sabha and the state assemblies were held in February 1967. The Congress was facing the electorate for the first time without Nehru. The result jolted the Congress at both the national and the state level. Many contemporary political observers described the election results as a political earthquake. The Congress did manage to get a majority in Lok Sabha, but with its lowest tally of seats and shares of votes since 1952. Half the ministers in Indira Gandhi's cabinet were defeated. The political stalwarts who lost in their constituencies included Kamraj in Tamil Nadu, S.K. Patil in Maharashtra, Atulya Ghosh in West Bengal, and K.B. Sahay in Bihar. The dramatic nature of the political change was more apparent at the state level. The Congress lost majority in as many as 7 states. In 2 other states, defections prevented it from forming a government. These 9 states where the Congress lost power were spread across the country. Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Orissa, Madras, and Kerala. In Madras state, now called Tamil Nadu, a regional party, the Dravid Munnetra Kadgam, came to the power by securing a clear majority. The DMK won after having led a massive anti-Hindi agitation by students against the center on the issue of imposition of Hindi as an official language. This was the first time any non-Congress party had secured a majority of its own in any state. In the other 8 states, coalition government consisting of different non-Congress parties were formed. A popular saying was that one could take a train from Delhi to Howrah and not pass through any single Congress-ruled state. It was a strange feeling for those who used to seeing the Congress in power. So, were the domination of the Congress over? Next point is coalitions. The election of 1967 brought into picture the phenomena of coalitions. Since no single party had got majority, various non-Congress parties came together to form joint legislative parties called Sanyukt Vidhayak Dal that supported non-Congress government. That is why these governments came to be described as SVD governments. In most of these cases, coalition partners were ideologically incongruent. The SVD government in Bihar, for instance, included the 2 socialist parties, SSP and the PSP, along with the CPI on the left and the Jan Sangh on the right. In Punjab, it was called the Popular United Front and comprised the 2 rival Akali parties at that time, Sant Group and the Master Group, with the both the communist parties, the CPI and CPIM, the SSP, the Republican Party and the Bharatiya Jan Sangh. Now let us discuss defection. Another important feature of the policies after 1967 election was the role played by the defections in the making and unmaking of the governments in the states. Defection means an elected representative leaves the party on whose symbol he or she was elected and joins another party. After the 1967 general election, the breakaway Congress legislatures played an important role in installing non-Congress government in three states, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh. The constant realignment and the shifting political loyalties in this period gave rise to the expression Ayaram Gayaram. Let us stop our lecture here. In the next lecture, we shall continue this chapter. Thanks for listening.